Did you run your Python code and it returned an error? We have some quick fixes to save your code. First, let's learn how to handle Python exceptions. The most common way is the try except method. Here's a simple example. We test the code with a try clause, and if it returns an exception, the accept block will run instead. You can also list multiple exceptions and provide different methods to handle each. This code snippet will print the error type, making it easy to identify what needs fixing. Another option is to write a general handler that can catch any type of exception. You won't be able to write specific ways to fix each error, but it will save you a couple of code lines. For more control over your code, add else and finally blocks. Like in this example, else runs if no exception occurs, while finally runs every time. It's like giving your code a plan B when something doesn't work. Now, you know how to catch any error, but how do we fix them? Here's a list of the most common ones. Getting a key error means you're accessing a key that's not in your array. First, check if the key has been defined yet. Look if the key names match and there aren't any typos. Name error is also very similar. It occurs when you call a non-existent variable, class, or function. Again, a simple fix. Define variables before calling them. It's important to remember that the names are case sensitive, so make sure the capitalization is correct. Import error and module not found error occur when a module is corrupted or can't be found. To solve it, double-check your import statements, avoid circular dependencies, and ensure the module file is in the correct directory. Typos here can also be a deal breaker. When you run an operation with an inappropriate data type, you will get a type error. For example, if you try adding a numeric value to a string, fix it by checking types of variables involved and mutate your objects. Next up, index error. Avoid accessing indexes beyond the sequence range, as shown in this example. You can use the length function to check the bounds. It's important to remember that Python is a zero-based language, meaning that the first item in the sequence will have a zero index. An attribute error occurs when the specified attribute can't be applied to the given object. To handle attribute error issues, check the documentation of the object. You can also use the hasAttribute function to see if the object has the attribute you're trying to use. To avoid the file not found error, check your file paths and names. Make sure the file is readable. By default, Python can read an open CSV, JSON, and XML files, but libraries allow even more possibilities, so double check if you've got the right tools. Another common mistake is the zero division error when you try dividing by zero. Manually review your operations, validate your data, and avoid division by zero scenarios. The value error exception is raised when a function receives an argument with an invalid value. To fix it, see if values are within the expected range and validate before they are used in operations or functions. That's all the quick fixes for typical Python errors. For more Python coding tutorials, check out this playlist. And I'll see you in another video.